Hello, makers. Today we are shooting with lasers. We have this laser distance sensor. It's the CJVL53LOXV2, or short VL53LOX sensor. It's a laser distance sensor. So, without further ado, let's solder the pin headers and try it out. Well, since the pin headers are soldered on, we could start the wiring. The magic the sensor does is contained in this little chip here. It acts like a microcontroller. And the datasheet said you have to feed the controller with 2.7 to 3.5 volts. Well, we could connect it to the 3.3 volts output, but if you have a look at this little thing here, it's marked as 662K. It's a voltage regulator. That suggests that this breakout board is also 5 volt compatible. Since I have two of them, I think I'll take the risk. So, let's hook it up. Well, of course, we need VCC. And as said, we are connecting it to 5 volts. Ground, of course, to ground. And we have SCL and SDA. That means we are connecting I2C. SCL, the clock line, is connected to A5. SDA to A4. So we have two pins left, GPIO1 and X-shut. With X-shut, you can turn the controller on the board on and off. And GPIO1 works as an interrupt for the controller. Let's see if this works with this minimal configuration. First of all, it's a good thing to check the I2C address. So we upload the I2C detect sketch and see if you can determine the I2C address of this chip. Well, as we can see, the I2C address is 29. So, let's see if you are lucky. Open the library manager and see if we can find a libs. VL. Oh, well, that was easy. And it's an Adafruit library. Let's install it. So, let's check the example to it. Adafruit, there we have it. Well, let's upload it and see what it does. Yeah, it works. Let's put the sensor here and use my hand. Yeah. That looks quite cool. Yeah, it seems to work. Let's check how accurate those values are. Well, I placed an object about 15 centimeters in front of the sensor. Yeah, that's our good values. Let's raise the distance. Okay. This must be 30 centimeters. Oh. This should be 30 centimeters. Ah. And because it was a black surface, the accuracy drops. Well, it seems to measure up to 125 centimeters. That's pretty neat. So let's walk through the code. Well, the code doesn't seem so hard. We include the library, we create an instance of the sensor, starting the serial monitor, and activate the sensor with begin. Well, that's straightforward. We have an object ranging measurement data and a function that fills this variable with the requested data. It has a status, and we can request the range in millimeters. Well, that's straightforward. For measuring distance, we had this sharp infrared sensor. It was quite expensive, with about 6 euros, and quite inaccurate. We had this ultrasonic sensor. High accuracy, up to 3 meters, and cheap as think, 1 euro. And now the laser distance sensor. And maybe it works better if we remove the protective skin here. Shooting lasers on objects. It costs about 6,50 euro. It has a high accuracy up to 1.25 meters. In compared to the other two, it's very, very tiny. So if you're in lack of space, this one would be an ideal sensor. With this breakout board, it works with 3.3 volts and 5 volts. It works on the I2C bus. There's already a good library for it. And maybe I will use it in my killer robot. Like it. Bye.